Hey friend, Jill Jackson here, and welcome to another video where I hope to encourage, energize, and equip you to just teach your heart out so you have the best school year ever. So I want to tell you about a time where my coach, a coach that helps me with my business and helps us serve our clients better and all of that, said to me something that changed everything. So I'll give you a little backstory and then how this of course ties into you. So I was working on creating new processes. We had put new books out and we were having trouble with the ordering process. It didn't seem to be working and it was like, ugh, this is awful. One thing wasn't working, we get it fixed, and the other thing wasn't working and all this. This was happening in my business, but you can relate to how this happens in your classroom, in your home, with your car. Fix one thing and another thing happens, whatever. It's kind of a general adult thing when all heck breaks loose, right? And I was in that moment. And there were some really good things going on where we were able to be able to support some new schools and teachers and school districts that really, really needed what we had. And that was really good news, but the good news kind of got lost in the shuffle. And so she had a little mini verbal intervention with me, I would call it. And what she said was, is Jill, and she said it very distinctly, Jill, I need you to choose to enjoy this process or I need you to not do it at all. And of course, at first I was a little like wounded, like licking my wounds, like, geez, she didn't have to get so aggressive and say like, Jill. But what she did was she caught my attention. And so she said, Jill, that caught my attention. And she said, what I need you to do is, she didn't just say, stop crabbing about the process. She said, I need you to stop complaining about what you're doing. And then she gave me a replacement behavior and start to get excited or start to get happy about what you're working on and start to enjoy it. And so I'm gonna say to you this, teacher, declare today that this is going to be an excellent school year, not because of the kids you get, not because of the colleagues that you're working with, not because of the classroom configuration that you have, or whether you got all that stuff that was on your wish list, or whether everybody showed up ready to learn and you are the perfect teacher for them this year. Regardless of all of that, you say to yourself, self, in my case, Jill, you better get excited about this. And I say to you, teacher, declare today that this is going to be the best school year that you have had. And by declaring, which by the way, is like no waffling. It just is what it is. When you declare something, there's no question about it. By declaring that this is going to be the best school year ever, it will be. Think about it this way. I was recently invited to an event. I did not want to go, but I knew I needed to go. You know, that kind of event where you're like, oh gosh, I just want to stay home and watch Bravo or something like that. Fill in the blank for your favorite channel. But I would really could have said, I would rather, you know, stay home and knit. And I don't even knit, but that's how badly I didn't want to go to this thing. So I'm driving. And you know, I'm a positive person. I tend to see the bright side of things, not the dark side of things. And I'm going to this thing and I'm like, I don't wanna go. My outfit looks stupid. This is so dumb. And there was this moment where my coach just blurted in my ear. She wasn't even there, but it came back to me. Jill, I need you to enjoy this, not to see it as a problem or not to see it as an issue. So I said to myself, self, there's a reason why you have to go to this thing. You better get excited. And so slowly, as I drove to the event, very slowly, because I didn't want to go, just kidding, I worked on my attitude. And by the time I got to the event, there was a friend there that I hadn't seen in forever, and I didn't know that she would be there. And it was like, oh my gosh, this is so fun. We're exchanging numbers. It's like, we've got to get together, and we really meant it. It wasn't even fake, we got to get together. And so I realized that I was meant to go to that event. My attitude was not right in the beginning. But in an instant, I declared, it's gonna be all right. It's gonna be good. And you have to do that for your kids. And you also have to do that for your colleagues. It's like standing in the gap when other people aren't quite there yet or your kids aren't quite there yet to see that this is gonna be a really great school year. We stand in the gap, you stand in the gap, I stand in the gap and say, it is a great school year because I said so, because I have declared it. And so your job and my job is to every single day, whether it's while you're driving in the car, while you're walking into your classroom from the staff lounge, wherever you do kind of your little thinking about the day, your job is to again and again and again and yet again declare that this is going to be a great school year simply because you said it was. Have a good day.